Alright, and welcome back to the final episode of this game, which is not truly a game, so, yeah. Alright, let's quickly finish this. I am getting kind of curious where this is all going though. Wait, what just happened? Alright then. Oh yeah, we rushed into the secret meeting.
And here. I feel reassured.
Sir Walter!
Gentlemen! This is Mr. Hannay, of whom I have spoken to you. I'm afraid, Hannay, this visit is ill-timed.
That remains to be seen, sir. But I think it may be in the nick of time. For God's sake, gentlemen, tell me who went out a minute ago.
Lord Alloa.
It was not. It was his living image, but it was not Lord Alloa. It was someone who recognized me, someone I have seen in the last month. He had scarcely left the doorstep when I rang up Lord Alloa's house and was told he had come in half an hour before and had gone to bed.
Who?
The Black Stone.
Nonsense!
Confirm the story.
I have spoken to Alloa. Had him out of bed, very grumpy. He went straight home after Malross's dinner.
But it's madness. Do you mean to tell me that that man came here and sat beside me for the best part of half an hour and that I didn't detect the imposture? Alloa must
be
out of his mind.
It's just one big game of Among Us. Well,
don't you see the cleverness of it? You were too interested in other things to have any eyes. You took Lord Alloa for granted. If it had been anybody else, you might have looked more closely, but it was natural for him to be here, and that put you all to sleep.
Young man is right. His psychology is good. Our enemies have not been foolish. I will tell you a tale.
I
it happened many years ago in Senegal.
Sure. Oh, he's gonna tell it anyway? Alright, alright. Interesting. Ah, it's another movie. I like how he leaves most of the fish on the ground, lying there. Not even taking it with him. Oh no, sport horse. An old man eater? Is it because the lion is old and he eats men, or is it because he only eats old men?
What happened?
Hmm.
I stuffed my fishing rod into his jaws, and I had a pistol. Also, my servants came presently with rifles. But he left his mark on me. Consider. The mare had been dead more than an hour, and the brute had been patiently watching me ever since. I never saw the kill, for I was accustomed to the mare's fretting, and I never marked her absence, for my consciousness of her was only of something tawny, and the lion filled that part. If I could blunder thus, gentlemen, in a land where men's senses are keen, why should we busy, preoccupied, urban folk not err also?
Well, I suppose there is nothing for it but to change the plans.
Did you tell Lord Alloa what has happened? No? Well, I can't speak with absolute assurance, but I'm nearly certain we can't make any serious change, unless we alter the geography of England.
Well, maybe we can.
God, and we have not a rag of a clue.
Besides, there is the post. By this time, the news will be on its way.
No. You do not understand the habits of the spy. He receives personally his reward, and he delivers personally his intelligence. We in France know something of the breed. Now, there is still a chance, mes amis. These men must cross the sea, and there are ships to be searched and ports to be watched. Believe me, the need is desperate for both France and Britain.
Where is Scudder's book? Quick, man! I remember something in it.
What is it going to be?
What could it be? 39 steps.
39 steps. 39 steps. I counted them. High tide, 10:17 p.m.
What relevance is all?
Don't you see? It's a clue. Scudder knew where these fellows laired. He knew where they were going to leave the country, though he kept the name to himself. Tomorrow was the day, and it was some place where high tide was at 10:17.
But they may have gone tonight.
Not they. They have their own snug, secret way, and they won't be hurried. I know Germans, and they are mad about working to a plan. Where the devil can I get a book of tide tables?
It's a chance. Let's go over to the Admiralty.
Holds her down. Oh, that's nice. I have the feeling that time might be running out. Don't know why though, just a hunch.
is the most I can make of it. We have got to find a place where there are several staircases down to the beach, one of which has 39 steps. I think it's a piece of open coast with biggish cliffs somewhere between the Wash and the Channel. Also, it's a place where full tide is at 10:17 tomorrow night. Is there no inspector of Coast Guards or some fellow like that that knows the East Coast?
Why, yes, there is. He lives in Clapham. Let me get him now. This is the chap.
Good evening, gentlemen.
We want you to tell us the places you know on the East Coast where there are cliffs and where several sets of steps run down to the beach.
What kind of steps do you mean, sir? There are plenty of places with roads cut down through the cliffs, and most roads have a step or two in them. Or do you mean regular staircases, all steps, so to speak?
We mean regular staircases.
I don't know that I can think of any. Wait a second. There's a place in Norfolk, Brattlesham, beside a golf course, where there are a couple of staircases to let the gentleman get a lost ball.
That's not it.
Then there are plenty of marine parades, if that's what you mean. Every seaside resort has them.
It's got to be more retired than that.
Well, gentlemen, I can't think of anywhere else. Of course, there's the Ruff.
What's that?
The big chalk headland in Kent, close to Bradgate. It's got a lot of villas on the top. And some of the houses have staircases down to a private beach. It's a very high-toned sort of place. And the residents there like to keep by themselves.
With what?
We're on the scent at last. How can I find out?
I guess that's the answer.
I can tell you that, sir. I once was let a house there in this very month, and I used to go out at night to the deep sea fishing. The tide's 10 minutes before Bradgate.
If one of those staircases has 39 steps, we have solved the mystery, gentlemen. I want the loan of your car, Sir Walter, and a map of the roads.
Of course.
If Mr. McGillivray will spare me 10 minutes,
yes,
I think we can prepare something for tomorrow.
Good. I, for one, am content to leave the matter in Mr. Hannay's hands.
After this, one more, and then finally, the first game will be finished. Well, it's not really a game still. I'll also be writing a review on this visual novel, I suppose. Griffin Hotel. All right.
34, 35, 42, 47, and 21, where the cliffs get lower. Oh, and 39. Scaife.
Pom pom pom. Oh, that's epic, man. See what this is about. It's a boat. Nice. Imposters? What? So sus. Sussy mockas. I can't believe this is straight up Among Us in book form. And very extensive. Suspicions. The sussies and the bussies. Oh, nice, man. I wonder who the imposter is, though. Like the real... big boss, big mafia boss type imposter boy.
You all right there, Percy?
Yes, you're looking a little hot under the collar.
I've got into a proper lather. This'll bring down my weight and my handicap, Bob. I'll take you on tomorrow and give you a stroke a hole.
Oh my god, that's so push. Wait, who is that again? I the time has come for the final chapter. Alright, let's finish this fecker. Oh my god. Excuse me. It's so boring though. Alright. Alright. We're gonna go through the front door. Alright. We're gonna unlock the pit. Oh, no, it's just a bell. Never mind. I am blind.
Is Mr. Appleton at home?
Yes, sir. Please come in.
Ooh. Who could it be?
Who may I say is calling?
Richard Hannay.
If you could wait in the smoking room, I'll let Mr. Appleton know you're here.
Wait, what mistake? That he told his real name?
Mr. Hannay? Did you wish to see me?
I think we have met before, and I guess you know my business.
Maybe. I haven't a very good memory, but I'm afraid you must tell me your errand, sir, for I really don't know it.
Well then, I have come to tell you that the game's up.
Nice.
I have a warrant for the arrest of you three gentlemen.
Arrest? Arrest? Good God, what for?
For the murder of Franklin Scudder in London on the 23rd day of last month.
I never heard
this. It would be pretty funny if these gentlemen are innocent.
You know. I heard about it. Good heavens. You must be mad, sir. Where do you come from?
Scotland Yard.
Don't get flustered, Uncle. It's all a ridiculous mistake. But these things happen sometimes, and we can easily set it right. It won't be hard to prove our innocence. I can show you that I was out the country on the 23rd of May, and Bob was in a nursing home. Mm. You were in London, but you can explain what you were doing.
Right, Percy. Of course, that's easy enough. The 23rd. That was the day after Agatha's wedding. Let me see, what was I doing? Came up in the morning from Woking and lunched at the club with Charlie Simons. Then, oh yes, I dined with the fishmongers. I remember, for the punch didn't agree with me, and I was seedy next morning. Hang it all, there's the cigar box I brought back from the dinner.
I don't know, man, it seems kind of legit.
I think, sir, you will see you are mistaken. We want to assist the law, like all Englishmen, and we don't want Scotland Yard to be making fools of themselves. That's so, Uncle?
Certainly, Bob. Certainly. We'll do anything in our power to assist the authorities, but this is a bit too much. I can't get over it.
How Nellie will chuckle. She always said you would die of boredom because nothing ever happened to you. Now, you've got it thick and strong.
Oh, that sounds quite familiar, doesn't it?
By Joe, yes. Just think of it. What a story to tell at the club. Really, Mr. Hannay, I suppose I should be angry to show my innocence, but it's too funny. I almost forgive you the fright you gave me. You looked so glum. I thought I might have been walking in my sleep and killing people.
Maybe it was the butler. It's usually the butler, right?
reassured by your scrutiny, sir? I hope you find it consistent with your duty to drop this ridiculous business. I make no complaint, but you see how annoying it must be to respectable people.
Oh, Lord. This is a bit too thick.
Do you propose to march us off to the police station? That might be the best way out of it, but I suppose you won't be content with the local branch. I have the right to ask to see your warrant. But I don't wish to cast any aspersions upon you. You're only doing your duty. But you'll admit, it's horribly awkward.
Well, he's right about one thing.
Meantime, I vote we have a game of bridge. It'll give Mr. Hannay time to think over things. And you know we've been wanting a fourth player. Do you play, sir?
Yes. Yes, I play.
Oh my god. Is this the grand reveal? Taps the same as the other guy, right? Yeah, exactly. Alright then, interesting. Well, now we know who they are.
Bob, look at the time. You better think about catching your train. Bob's got to go to town tonight.
I'm afraid he must put off his journey.
Oh, damn. I thought you'd drop that rot. I simply got to go. You can have my address. And I'll give you any security you like.
No, you must stay.
I'll go bail for my nephew. That ought to content you, Mr. Hannay.
Get your hands off me!
Schnell, Franz, das Boot!
Well, there's now no doubt anymore, I suppose. Holy shit, that's an explosion, man. Yeah.
He is safe. You cannot follow in time. He's gone. He has triumphed. Der Schwarze Stein ist in der Siegeskrone.
What's he talking about? Still have no clue. Alright, so now wait.
I hope Franz will bear his triumph well. I ought to tell you that the Ariadne for the last hour has been in our hands.
Ooh. Oh, that's the end? Well, that's, I don't know. It feels a little bit anticlimactic or something. Alright. Well, thanks for watching, I guess, everyone. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And we now have finished our first game from the entire library. So that's nice, I suppose. Oh, I can't skip this. Can I? Oh. Alright, okay. Alright, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.